Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 16 Beta 6. This is available to developers. Usually it's been coming out the following day for public beta testers. So iOS 16 Public Beta 4, you can expect that as late as tomorrow. Hopefully it's today though. Now, as you can see, it says 16.0 for some reason. Again, with beta 5, they did this, and beta 6. They're only doing it with iOS 16. It's a little confusing, so I wish they would add beta 6 after that, but this is beta 6. And it came in at 426.5 megabytes. That's on my 13 Pro Max, and it was about 400 to 500 megabytes on all the devices here. So it's a fairly small update. Now, along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 16 Beta 6, WatchOS 9 Beta 6, tvOS 16 Beta 6, and HomePod OS 16 Beta 6. So far, there's no macOS 13 Ventura Beta 6. Now let's take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, we'll go to General, then About. And as you can see, the build number is 20A5349B. This particular update brings us closer and closer to a final release. As that letter counts down to the letter A, A usually is the final before the release candidate. So that's a pretty good sign. Now, also, this is 2.09.01 for the modem firmware update. That's the same as beta 5 for me on the 13 Pro Max. Each device has a little bit different number though. Now, as far as new features, well, the first thing has to do with contacts. So if we go into contacts, you can see at the top of contacts, it found a duplicate. There's a new little box that pops up. If it finds a duplicate, saying merging duplicate cards for the contacts combines the cards, keeping all unique information in a single card for that contact. It will also let us know if it's been updated as far as different updates for phone numbers and names across your contacts. There'll be a little pop-up box for that. Now, the battery percentage was brought back with the last update with beta 5, and as you can see, it's here, and there's a small animation change with that. So if we go back, go to our battery, go to battery percentage, as I change it, it's nice and smooth now where it animates quickly. Unfortunately, it's still not available on the other devices such as the iPhone XR, 11, 12 mini, and 12 or 13 mini. Some people have told me they've seen it on the iPhone XR, but they weren't able to send me any proof that it was on the XR. So maybe it's there for some. I'd love to hear from you if you're seeing it. Within music, they've made a slight change as well. If we go into music and then maybe we're playing a song, and on the lock screen where we have our little widget, tap on the album art, they've actually changed the size of this again. It's smaller where it was larger on the previous beta. That's something I'm not as happy with, as I liked the larger sort of overall album art on the lock screen. I think it looked better with the larger album art, but it's a small change in this update. Now, if you're within an app and you're in landscape mode, and then you pull down the notification center, before they move the time to the right, it doesn't look very good. The widget is sort of centered. In beta 6, they've updated this. So if we rotate Safari, do the same thing. We'll pull down the notification center and you'll see it looks much better. Time is on the left with our little weather widget above it. And then you have your music widget to the right and then your focus status. This looks much, much nicer in beta 6. Now, if we go into settings, go over to notifications, under notifications, there we go. Under notifications, they've changed some of the wording toward the top. As we get closer to a final release, you're going to see more and more refinement. So we have, let me swap these. We have beta 5 on the left, beta 6 on the right. And as you can see, the text is simpler where it says choose the default for how notifications appear, where you can change from count to stack to list. So they're just clarifying some of that text there. Also, text has been updated in the weather app. So this was sort of in beta 5, but also beta 6. So if we go into our settings here, if it reacts, there we go. So we'll try this again, go into our settings here for notifications. And some of the wording is changed at the top where it says, if you enable severe weather notifications, Apple can associate the country or region of these notifications with your Apple ID. So that's a small change, not really anything big, but something they've updated. There'll also be a new message if we go into settings and maybe you're using Private Relay under iCloud Plus. And if you are using Private Relay and your subscription to iCloud Plus has expired, there will be a new message saying that it's actually expired and no longer available and that it's turned off. So that's something you'll see. It wasn't there before. Now, last week with iOS 16 Beta 5, on the iPhone, when many people rebooted it, they would get a message that they need to unlock their SIM. People using Beta 6 on the iPad are seeing the same sort of thing. So some might see the SIM unlock message. That's the same thing here, where you can unlock your SIM and then use your iPad with cellular. I have cellular on this. I didn't see that message, but some people are seeing that pop up when they reboot. So just wanted to make you aware of that. There's no other changes on the iPad that we're aware of yet, other than what I've mentioned for the iPhone so far. And as we get closer to the final release of iOS 16, there's going to be less and less changes. There are more code and wording changes throughout the OS, specifically promoting things such as Apple Pay, Tap to Pay with someone else, and much more. So that's something we'll see more, although I didn't get a pop-up when I opened up Apple Wallet for that. There are no new splash screens that I've seen this time around going into all the different Apple apps. I haven't seen any of those. Now, additionally, within wallpaper, if we go into our wallpaper and maybe we've added a ton of different wallpaper, we'll get to a point where we'll actually get a message now telling us that there's too many wallpapers and we actually need to delete one in order to add a new one. I wasn't able to reach this limit yet. I tried with all of these different wallpapers and I'm not sure what the limit is. I'll have to figure that out in a future update, but maybe 20, maybe 50, maybe 100. I'm not really sure yet, but apparently there is a message there that you will see once you hit that limit. And one thing I've noticed as far as fixed issues in this update is the wallpaper menu bug is fixed and I can set wallpapers without an issue. I was able to set all of these different wallpapers quickly without any problems. So that's a nice thing to see. They've sort of refined that finally. Also, they've updated Spotlight Search, so it's actually working this time around. You'll see I typed in Apple and it searches right away. So again, if I type Apple, it searches right away, gives suggestions if we have that turned on, gives apps and more. So it's working much better where it wasn't working in Beta 5. Now, there are some resolved and known issues still in this update, and if we go into our feedback app, we can see the release notes. So notes and known issues, there's still 11 known issues, and there's some resolved issues as well. So again, that same issue we had before is still a known issue. You'll see it says Beta 6 release notes. The pointer won't behave correctly on an external display if the assistive touch accessibility feature is enabled. The workaround is to disable it with an external display. So they still haven't fixed some of these issues. They did resolve an issue where devices running beta 4 or later aren't backward compatible with devices running earlier beta versions. So that's been updated. The emoji known issue is still here. The search field for emoji lock screen editor is missing. And of course, these notes are available to everyone and I'll link them in the description. But again, another known issue for home is the device that initiates the pairing needs to use the same iCloud account as the home hub. Only the owner of a home, not an invited user, can pair Matter accessories. So again, I'll link these in the description. Quite a few fixes throughout the whole beta set, but there's still more to be done. Now, there are additional code changes with small wording and more. We'll visit more of that in the follow-up. Now, let's talk about performance, as performance seems to be quite good. Even on the previous betas, many people said they had no issues with this. But if we open up music on the 8 Plus, one of the oldest supported devices, scroll through, everything's nice and fast. If we go to the library, that sync is off. We'll go to listen now, and everything's loading quickly. As far as games and more, again, Minecraft I've tested many times. It seems to load quickly this time around, much quicker than previous betas. So we resumed there. No issues there. You'll see it's drawing the background, so the draw distance is typical. Everything is smooth, except for that little jump there, but it was smooth earlier when I was trying this out, and seems to be what you would expect on older devices. As far as initial benchmarks, now we do talk more about this in the follow-up video, but let's take a look at Geekbench scores, at least on the 13 Pro Max. On the 13 Pro Max, it scored 1,738 for single core, 4,681 for multi-core. This typically improves over the next few days or so, but as you can see here, it was a little bit better previously for multi-core. Single core was better this time around. So again, this usually improves over days. We'll talk more about that in the weekly follow-up video at the end of the week. Now, also the iPhone is staying nice and cool, whether I'm running Geekbench tests or more. So I think they're really managing the processor, really nailing things down, getting things much more stable and all the features locked in this time around with iOS 16 Beta 6 or public Beta 4. Now, as far as the overall battery life, previous betas have been pretty good for me. My battery health is now at 99%. I talked about that last week. So that's pretty good given that it's been almost well, a year at this point. Yesterday's battery life was okay, not great. I did go to bed with about 50%, but I don't use my phone as much on the weekend. So if we go back to Friday, where I use it a little bit more, screen on time was 3 hours and 45 minutes. Screen off time was 2 hours and 53 minutes. And I used about 60% of my battery. So not particularly great. It is a beta. Usually I'm using about 8 to 10 hours of screen on time. But by the time I go to bed, I have about 50% of my battery life left. I put it on the charger and then take it off in the morning. Now, as far as the next beta release date, well, we're moving right along here. And so I would expect the next beta early next week. We had beta 5 last Monday. I would expect beta 7 on the 22nd, although they could push it out to Tuesday or Wednesday. Then we would have maybe the release candidate on the 29th, if we're going to have an Apple event, maybe we'll have a release candidate then or a little bit after, and then possibly an Apple event on the 6th, as many are predicting at this point. We could have it on the 6th or the 13th based off previous years. Well, they'll show off the next iPhone, iPhone 14 and the 14 Pro models, and then give us a final date of when to expect iOS 16. So all of those things are just a few weeks away. If it is going to be on the 6th, I would expect Apple invites for the event to go out either next week or the week after that, depending on when they plan to release that event. So hopefully we'll see all of that very soon. I can't believe it's already toward the end of iOS 16 and close to iPhone 14, but we're getting there very, very quickly. Now, if you found anything else in iOS 16 beta 6, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, in the follow-up later this week, we'll talk about whether or not you should install iOS 16 beta 6 or wait for the final release if you haven't already. Again, let me know if you found anything in the comments below. And if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.